Shengo may have been one of the first people in South Florida to experience the impact of the virus. He grew up near Wuhan, China, where the virus started. His parents and grandmother still live close to the city. He's an economics instructor at FIU. When we spoke with him from his Weston home in late February, his family in China had been living in a lockdown region for a month.
Since like January 22, 23rd, my parents have been quarantined in their apartment.
Guo's early personal experience and his economic training helped him foresee what would be in store for South Florida as the virus made its way here.
My name is Sheng Guo. I am an instructor of economics at Florida International University, and I grew up in Yincheng, China, which is a small city 45 miles from Wuhan, Hubei province. My parents are still living there, as well as my grandma, and I have relatives and friends living there. Usually I would communicate with them in my bedroom or in my home office at my home in Western Florida. It made my heart heavy, to say the least. You know, sometimes it's very depressing because the news can become so scary that I don't want to monitor it anymore. But because of them, I have to stick with it. In the very beginning of the outbreak, the best public policy is to contain the outbreak. And that is also the best economic policy because you want to contain it as soon as possible so everything can get back to normal. But in the medium and the long run, the best public policy, which is a quarantine, may not be the best economic policy. And that will cause a problem for an economy. This kind of fear, this kind of having to deal with the unknown factor of this new thing, that can make people scale back their decisions. My wife, she is a faculty member in a business school of Florida International University. She specializes in healthcare economics. My wife and I, we talk about it every day. I hope it can end some days because this is not something good for us to talk about. I hope it can end.
FIU economics instructor Sheng Guo. He lives in Weston. We first spoke with him in late February. Since then, he says his parents near Wuhan are almost back to a new normal, wearing masks and getting their temperatures checked in public. He had been talking with them every couple of days when they were ordered to stay home. He doesn't speak with them nearly as often anymore. It's now their time to worry about us, he says.